Good day, friends. Good day, lovely humans. I just bid for you to this day find you in a peace, in a lot of joy, and some nice nature, maybe an espresso or two, maybe a cake, but no steaks. No other beings' meat or flesh. I think you had enough. Even you feel it, that is not the same anymore. This flesh of these animals doesn't taste right. Something is going bad. So are they going to wake up, the animals, and tell you, please, that was it? No more carnivoring, no more cannibalism. Yet you can say cannibalism is only if you eat a human flesh. Little babies, medium-sized babies, or adult, or even dead people. Bringing them, you know, digging them out of the grave or upon their death. So you don't do big crime if you're eating one who died so-called naturally. So title for today: do you still have to die hundreds of times to learn to live once and for all? There's a second part of this title, but it's way too long, so I'll just go to the point. You will not have any choices anymore, which is kind of good. To die again and again and reborn and die again. So you will not play this human cattle reincarnation cycle where we have been fed continuously to these creatures that nobody want to talk about. So why nobody want to talk about freaking aliens? They were our masters, they are hidden puppeteers, they are hidden cattle human breeders. Why we are not daring to talk about it? It's the same perspective as the chickens and the cows and the pigs. They don't complain about their captures humans, or down the road their consumers, humans who are going to consume them. They don't even know at that point they are ready to be, or they are bred only to be eaten. So when you put yourself in the position of the chicken or a cow or a pig, by knowing that you are this pig who lives in the barn to be eaten, doesn't matter by who, because they are changing timelines, they are picking you, they are cloning you. So do you exist on many different synthetic timelines where they basically do the same thing? They just feed off you. I mean, what's the reason? Because you never said, please stop. You don't have to say please, but anyway, this is my vocabulary that you cannot say, fuck off, I don't want to be eaten anymore. And by this choice of the words, you can actually really stop dying. Because when people are sending the wars, or suddenly eruption of a major heavy disease comes in, and like Spanish flu kills like 20 million in a matter of months, what is that? It's nothing else but a big sacrificial dinner that these aliens were just like getting so upset and angry and hungry, and they need something big, because they cannot just nibble a bones. Like, I cannot eat just children, like, you know, one at every couple of hours. I want like a feast of hundreds of thousands of flesh, dead flesh humans to consume. Make a big pile of it, drain their blood, you know, make a special sausages of so and so, you know, names with the special ingredients of different variety of nations and the colors, yet all the blood is so, you know, red and very rejuvenating for them. So why nobody talks about it? Why nobody wanna stop being eaten? You tell me. I mean, try to tell yourself why you have to die so many times before. Why you cannot stop deteriorating now? Where are you alive, let's say alive, in this physical form, in this lifetime, in 21st century, 2017, you are going to die soon, right? You're getting older, you're getting hit by a meteor or vaccines or surgery or medications or doesn't matter, a war or like a family dispute and just somebody throws a big chunk of furniture on your head and somebody was hungry, so you have to die. I'm not ridiculizing this at all. This is a real truth. This is how these fuckers are treating us humans. So, and how come they keep us in this kind of perpetual oblivion? Every life we come in and they're pretending we'll wipe your memory clean and new agers are so happy we saw coming clean here, not remembering a fucking thing from the previous life or all the other ones. I mean, the point is, if you remember a single thing, how many times you've been eaten, sacrificed, killed, executed, burned, eventually sometimes eaten alive on the table, and you would never, first of all, decide to die again. So this is the biggest secret of their so-called success over a blindfolded humanity, over totally unaware humanity, that we are here to live our puny lives for 50, 60, 100 years and we'll be so happy because we achieved a material wealth, or we didn't die from earthquake, but we die from a worse, you know, chemical poisoning by chemotherapy or by any kind of medications they are inventing these days. And they are very good for your health, of course. No. They're very good to stuff your meat, your flesh, with a product they actually enjoy. With, of course, your flesh and meat energy that remains for quite some time in your bones, in your flesh, in your blood, in any kind of secretions. Our energy is absolutely precious. It's like the best possible dessert for these fuckers. So, what to do not to be eaten again? Okay, nice statement here. Those who do not know their past are condemned to repeat it again, again and again. So you will just free willingly give them all your rights to be eaten, to be abused, to be sold, to be resold, to be cloned, to be recloned for centuries, for hundreds of thousands of years. I ask you a simple question. Did you had enough of being a human cattle? Did you had enough of being constantly abused, and some of these things are coming down as fake gods and presenting how you are so developing yourself, you are growing, your spirituality is growing, you just have to assign to this course, to this guru, and he'll only eat some of your things, but the rest will take it. And what they infuse in every single human being on this planet is actual cannibalism among us, between the people. And I'm not talking about just physical eating of flesh or drinking blood or whatever, eating the products. They pretend they are a chicken or a cow or a pig, but it's actually a human meat and human, you know, things within. But it's about human against human goes by emotional feeding. The feeding of the mental abuse, feeding of all the kind of abuses that we do to each other. So when and how to stop it? But only if you want. If you don't want, you'll be eaten very, very fast. You'll be devoured in a millisecond. Don't get me wrong, I don't judge any of these people who don't ever want to hear this. But now, as we have these kind of technologies, because most of these, let's say, human clones, they don't hear a connection with the Prime Creator. Because Prime Creator is just telling every single one of us, get the grip and get out of this situation. Now, because it will be very soon too late. It's already late if you consumed into any kind of addictions. Addictions like alcohol, drugs, fear, shopping, watching soap operas, watching games, being medicated by these freaks of doctors or pharmaceuticals, being actually legally poisoned. And this is what I tell you, they are legal poisoners, doctors and pharmaceutical guys, and these biologists and microbiologists. What the fuck they have to do into microbiology? They cannot even see how ugly they are. Why they don't fix something on their own out skin to look basically more humans? So anyway, the best trick they've done on us, try to hide our true history. And we, if we don't want to look into this direction and find the real true history, will be actually eaten very, very soon. And this time, there is no more coming back, because the ones who are eating you are deleted by millions, by planets, by civilizations, or called civilizations, because they're not civil. They're just like carnivores. They're just like eat everything and anything, including each other, these creatures. So this kind of energy and this kind of behavior, then transferring to us. So we as humans, we start abusing each other, killing each other in the wars, basically eating each other energy by forcing a certain opinions on others, forcing certain actions on others, because you are a chief, you are a lawyer, you are an advocate, you are whatever, a banker, you are somebody better than somebody else, you are a scientist. So you give all this lies and deception to feed on these pure, puny little human cattle. So, what's the solution for all this? Start learning a real story from the past. Real one. Don't doubt a second if something is absolutely ludicrous, that something doesn't have any sense, it's probably very close to the real truth, than these fake wars, fake diseases. They're not fake in the sense they didn't kill anybody, but the way how they were presented to you, they are fakely presented. So let's say there are real diseases who were fakely input into the history. And by this, you will learn nothing. You will just do the same thing. You will come blindfolded. You will not even dare to remove your blindfold to see, maybe I can live a bit different. Maybe I can do something different to save myself from this constant and perpetual, I don't know, disgrace of human flesh, that we totally disregarded our physical body and turned it into a feeding ground for these freaking aliens. They did not do this once, twice. They did it civilization after civilization after civilization. Some of our civilizations, they've been here. And we pretend we know what's happened in Atlantis or in Lemuria or in like Egypt, like just go 3,000 years before. We have no idea. We don't have idea who these half birds, half things were. Who were they, these people or these creatures? These are the aliens who are eating the rest. Yet nobody is talking about this openly. Now these creatures exist in the forms of doctors, elite, bankers, lawyers, medical, and all this royal elite who doesn't even come into the public because the owners of the barn doesn't go into the barn and mingle with the cows. So when the queen, so-called queen, the Lizzie, comes down among the crowds, it's like a farmer goes and sits in the shit of the pig and bathe in the sink. No, she doesn't want to do this. Yet, I think time has come for her to absolutely disclose what has been happening and why she is, or it is, because has no, I call it, gender, because these creatures have really like one gender, eat everything. They don't procreate like, let's say, human when they need male and female. They just clone things. Yet these cloned things have no energy. They have no human energy. So this is why we are so valuable to them, or we were so valuable, because as of last week, they are not anymore, especially the reptilian creatures. What you see now among these, let's say, top leaders or elitists or royals, they're just really like a clone left over to die or to completely disappear in front of your eyes, or to be charged for the crimes against humanity when the truth comes in. So I implore you, dig into the real past of you as a human and look around and see how close your barn is, how little space you have, how little hay that you have in the corner, and who's providing this hay. Can you find a door outside of your barn?